You want 40? You got 40. The most consistent list in the game. Let's go. Hey, yeah, 10 negates is cool and all, but why don't you just put up 6 negates every single turn through any hand trap the most consistent way possible? Let's go. The most consistent possible way to put up 6 negates with as little bricks in the deck. In fact, we only drew the one in the deck, Destrudo. No Mary Mary, no Utopia Double, just the cleanest, freshest list possible to ensure you get out everything you needed to play through hand traps with 6 servants in a 33 card deck because you're playing 7 draw cards. Now, let's get straight into it. I'm gonna show you guys a combo first, the most consistent way to do the combo, and then how to play through all hand traps, except Droll. Even Droll a little bit, but not really. But everything else obliterates it, and you build the deck in order to do it, the most consistent way to get servant and to stop all actual hand traps. So without further ado, hit the subscribe button and let's go. I'll show you guys the deck profile at the very end. You're gonna fast forward here. You're gonna get servant. You play 33. It's a 33 card deck, and you get servant. Destrudo bricks a little bit, but it's just the most consistent list possible. And Demon even isn't good either to draw. You don't want to draw these cards like the big Demon. Keep going here. Bring on Jackal. That's how you play through hand traps. Everyone knows this part of the combo. You don't even need to use Electrum at all. This deck is not even reliant on Electrum. It's a fact. You always have scales. So you literally use it as bait for impermanence. If they don't, you want to look on your face. When you use Electrum's effect, always, we said Dragon Call. We don't need Dragon Call, but a Surgery with Pen Call. You literally just use it as bait. There's nothing we could send to help us. You're like before you use Electrum's effect, you got to look at your hand a lot. Like, Electrum effect. I probably would have even saved the Duelist Alliance if I had to. Electrum effect. So if they use Imperm on Electrum, then it's like useless. But even then, it'll still be useless. It doesn't matter what they have. Pen Call, Destrudo. Now look at this. So we got poison. That was a mistake. Okay, there we go. Now people stop doing it. They take absolute out of the deck. I don't know why you take absolute out of the deck when if they go soaker, they don't even play Jackal or Servant. It's absolutely stupid. Some builds are absolutely horrible. They don't play Servant. They don't play nothing. You're just asking to lose 2 hand traps. So now if they if you hand trapped Electrum, you lost because I literally sent and I didn't need the send whatsoever. Do you go absolute? So usually you don't even use the effect. Now you bring a vortex to protect everything. So now even if they had an impermanence or double hand trap, they still lose. So there is no correct time to hand trap because there's nothing to hand trap. And if you were to ash, what are you going to ash my shrine? I don't give a shit. Like, literally nothing happened. And then you go this and Demian effect, 6 negates. And you couldn't do anything. Like, there's no hand trap to stop it. And it's 40 cards with only consistent cards in the deck with no breaks. The only card you don't want to draw is Destrudo. And even then, Destrudo is great to draw. It's a free turbo card and it's how you play going second. Drawing Destrudo is fantastic going second. There's no Yaz in the deck either. But when they see Destrudo going second, they instantly use Impermanence, Widow Anchor because they're scared of Yazzie. So they, and then they jokes on you. You just wasted a card to make it level 7. Then you Phoenix the other card. This is the deck profile. Triple Servant, Triple Mastery. Best cards in the deck hands down. Because you play a 33 card deck with these 7 draw cards, we cut Into the Voids in a 40 card deck because there's no space. Into the Void's a fantastic card. I literally want to play 43 with Into the Void, but there wouldn't be a 40 card deck then, would it? Servant is just so good that you want to make sure you see it every hand. It makes hand traps literally obsolete. It does nothing to you whatsoever. You play Triple Chrono, Triple Curtain Razor. You play 25 spells in the 24 spells because Chronograph and Curtain Razor leave the scale. Curtain Razor does not conflict with Dark Worm because you have 4 Foolishes and Shrines. What happens if they ash one? You have no Curtain Razor. What happens if you don't draw one? You need to get that free summon. Curtain Razor is absolutely necessary. The fact that people play Gate Zero Magicians, aka Purple Poison, Black Fang, and more than 1 or 2, absolutely baffles me. Those cards do nothing. You only play Pendulum Call because of Harmonizing. They're not good in the grind game. Purple Poison's not good in the grind game. Black Fang doesn't help in the grind game. What the hell are you using it for? You even took Absolute out of the deck. How the hell are you putting an XYZ? How the hell are you putting a Dark Spellcaster in the graveyard? You're not. Just stop like playing Black Fang. The card's absolutely garbage. Until Appalooza comes out and until some deck utilizes Appalooza like crazy, then you play Black Fang. But right now, it's absolutely shit. Curtain Razor's 10 times better than them all. Triple Dark Worm, I kind of want to cut it to 2, to be honest, but Desire's Banish is 2 too much, and sometimes you lose your targets for LP, you need to play 3. Double Harmonizing, Dragon Collar, Dragon Pit, Purple Poison. You only want to play 3 of them. Dragon Collar is how you play through hand traps when they interrupt the LP or your Agar Pain. If they interrupt the LP, let's say they ash your LP, you could still do Agar Pain by making anything a dragon with Dragon Collar. It ensures your hand traps go, your plays go through. If you don't play Dragon Collar or Curtain Rage, it's just like you've never played You never played for someone good. You never been hand trapped 3 times before and it shows. You never been hand trapped 2x before and it shows. Your LP hasn't been hand trapped 1x before and it shows. One Dragon Caller lets you play through all of that. Like, LP means nothing at all. And one Dragon Pit, which is a million times better than Black Fang. You now have 6 outs to Mystic Mind main deck, plus all the infinite inside in the side deck. Pearl Poison, Time Gazer, a lot of times playing Call Surge and Time Gazer to normal to protect Servant. One Jackal, one Endymion, all you need. If Desires banishes it, who gives a shit? Playing a bunch of one-offs with Desires in a 40-card deck doesn't matter whatsoever, because there's so many different lines of plays that it doesn't matter whatsoever what you banish at all. One Gate Zero, one Destroyer, only noobs can't play if you banish your Destroyer or your Jackal, who gives a shit? Or your Endymion, only noobs can't play if you banish it, who cares? You just play to go through a different route. Triple Mastery, four Pencall. Because you're playing a 33-card deck, you end up searching Pencall a lot. I could play Pencall 5 if I want, but you're playing a 33-card deck. There's no reason to. And you could play 5 Pencall, it's not wrong, or 6 isn't even wrong. 4 Foolish is absolutely correct. You need to see this card. You need to make sure Dark Realms engraved, and if not, you need to send it. It's a whole Guard Dragons. This whole deck is relying on Guard Dragons. But yeah, Dragon Caller just in case. This deck just amazing. So clean and fresh. 7 draw cards. If you, like I said, Desires, you banish anything, who gives a shit? I said this multiple times before, this side deck is the best side deck in the game for this entire meta. It's very simple. Draw one and you win versus any matchup. Triple Sphere, triple Super Poly destroys anything that's combo related. Triple Denko, triple Super Poly destroys Salamangreats. Triple Denko, double Spell Cancel, double Reboot destroys any Mystic Mind deck. Triple Denko, triple double Spell Cancel destroys Sky Striker. And when I say destroy, I mean draw one and you auto win of these 13 cards. And these are just the best Super Poly targets. Extra deck now. One Electrum, one B-Cop. Having a B-Cop is good because it allows you now with different situations that with Dragon Caller especially, or having Chronograph in hand, if your Electrum gets Gamma or Ghost Ogre, a lot of you don't know what the hell to do. Having B-Cop with Dragon Caller ensures that your Guard Dragon combo will still resolve. Playing Guard Dragons and not Dragon Caller, it just baffles me. And the fact that people play Garnet Gate Zero Magicians like Black Fang or Purple Poison in excess of one over Dragon Caller is even more baffling. One LP, one Triple Burst, one Aggar Pain, one Seal. Like, actually ask yourself this question. It actually baffles me. How many times have you actually used Purple Poison or Black Fang's effect in an actual competitive duel that actually did something? And when Black Fang or Dengirsu to attack over, it doesn't fucking count. When have you actually used it, and when has it actually helped? Aside from negging one. Never. Not in this format. In future, past formats, oh for sure. Purple Poison Black Fang was fantastic. How many spellcasters are you even playing in your deck? Like dark spellcasters. Like, just don't be stupid, okay? In past formats, they're great. In future formats, they're gonna be great. But this, not in this format. Especially when you need to see Pencall. Next, okay, one Aggar, one Seal, one Star. So Usurer is how you get Absoluto. So many people save their hand trap for LP. Now it's not gonna do shit because your Vortex comes out. No one plays Absolute anymore, and it's so stupid because it's how you play through hand traps. The normal versions, like no offense, Jeremy Mitchell, I'm cool with the guy, but hey, the version that you guys copy his, the Pendulum World's like sheep, right? One person tops and I'll play, which is cool because when I top infinity amount of times when I'm unbanned in a month or 2 months, everyone's gonna play my builds, obviously. But that version loses to one hand trap, anything, Veiler, Ghost Ogre, Impermanence, literally any hand trap in the game on LP, Ash, literally anything. But now if you Absolute before, your whole play resolves and your opponent is literally saving their, hitting Electrums wrong. Because everyone, if you hit LP, they Pendulums go one hand trap one Savage Dragon and pass. Which is like, if you have Absolute now, you doesn't matter, your whole play resolves and you have 6 negates. And you need 3 or 4 Spell Trap negates for Mystic Mind, because Sky Striker Mind is still a deck. They have easily 4 cards that need, 4 or 5 cards in the open that need to be negated or you lose. So now that you have 4 Spell Trap negates first turn every turn, they can't do that. And it looks like a lot of cards are going first, but all these cards you also utilize going second. Because of Dragon Caller and Dark Worm and all the ways you go into Dark Worm, you still go Guard Dragon combo going second. But you bring up Boreal Sword instead of the other cards. And sometimes you go Vortex and bounce a card, and you still go Boreal Sword on top with the Seal and stuff. Aggar Pain and LP. I was playing Boreal Load before as well, because you go Boreal Sword and Boreal Load easily going second, but I took it out in favor of all 3 Nightmare cards. The Nightmare cards are so good going second, and I hate playing cards like Dark Rebellion, XYZ Dragon. It does nothing. 4,000 damage, who gives a shit? cards like this, you can use at any level, and it now you don't have the restriction of having to play level 4s. You don't have any level 4s in the deck. Level 4s suck. You don't want to play cards just because they're level 4, but they suck. Fire Poison and Black Fang suck, and you're only playing them because they're level 4. But when you have an extra deck full of links that just destroy your opponent going second, it's far better. Guys, that's the list. I hope you like it. Try it out for yourself. You destroy everyone. It's so fresh, never breaks, so clean. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hit the subscribe button. I'll see you in tomorrow's video. Peace.